between talking with Melanie Kirby, Todd Bates, and myself, Todd noticed the bees seemed to really like his plant that he was growing, Oregano de la Sierra, or Monarda fistulosa, which is a native bee balm, grows up in the mountains. And they think that there's possibly some health benefit from feeding on those flowers. We're hoping that we find that it is like a natural source of some of the chemicals that are already used in like bee remedies.
Saw it as a potential to be medicinal or to offer self-medicative potential for the bees themselves, because they know certain things that they need nutritionally, or their hive may need certain compounds in order to maintain their health.
We've also looked into what the plant probably contains, some constituents like carvacrol, thymol, which have been shown to have antimicrobial and anti-mite effects in different other trials with other livestock. What this project is essentially doing is feed the bees, give them access to the oregano flowers. So we're sampling live bees. They're going to the USDA Bee Lab in Beltsville, Maryland, and they're gonna do some pretty specific virus and other disease assays. We're also taking bees, or we're actually preserving them in a bottle of saline, and they're gonna go to the BIP, or Bee Informed Partnership, which is nationwide beehive health database. Then we're also grabbing at least 10 to 15 mils of honey. It's freshly gathered, and we assume that it's stuff that they have only gathered in the last 2 weeks since they've been at Todd's. So if they had access to the oregano and whatever else was in the surroundings, of course, from the one under the net, we hope it's just from that one plant. We're able to say this has so much of it, so much of these compounds in it. And then the pollen is going out to San Juan College, where we've got a couple of cooperators, Dr. Don Hyder and Eric Miller, a professor of biology and chemistry respectively. And they're gonna do the chemical analysis on what is in the honey. And then also a little bit of paleontological or pollen analysis. So they're gonna be able to tell what plants the bees have been visiting.
So we suspected that they were gonna be able to self-medicate, and that was our hope. And the analysis that we get back from our various samples will help us to better understand what those components are and if indeed it is preferential for the bees.
You know, Todd works with oregano as basically a flavor, an herb that you can add to your cooking. But we hope that maybe this will bring about a natural product, or a plant that could be used in reseeding, re-veg mixes, habitat enhancement, in pollinator gardens, that will add something medicinal. Besides just food, it's food and medicine.
Eye on Research is a production of New Mexico State University.